pass or fail, you decide. Upcycling a service.
Hello and welcome to Upcycling SOS. I want to thank everybody for watching the first video. It's a good response. Chuffed to bits. Remember, help me out. Comment down below on what you would do on all the shorts, just so I can get another idea, because at the moment, I'm still learning. So, my original idea of a dark grey blending down to a light grey, it's kind of the same, just reverse. So it's going to go from a light blending down to a dark. I'm going to have stenciling all over the top. Probably be the same design. You come in a block, I don't know, square about that big. So I can fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And that'll be in black. The sides will not have any stenciling. It's just going to be the blend from the light grey down to the dark. These are going along with this, and it's going to be replaced with handles I've yet to buy, because I want to see how it looks first. In my mind, I've got a black handle, a double handle, maybe ones you can raise up and down. So that's what I'm going to do with that one. I want to see what the finish is like. That'll best choose the handle afterwards. Because I'll have a look to see which ones would be the best ones. I've got one in my head, but I want to really make this one look nice, because it's my first blend. I may as well try and make it look good. And the other thing I'm going to do to it is I'm going to attach legs to it. Now I've got legs because not a lot of people have them on the deck anymore, or on the floor if you're not navy savvy. So it's going to be raised. I'll attach two beams coming from this side obviously to that side, and the same over there, and it'll strengthen it a little bit as well. And then attach the legs. The wood will be hidden by the kickboard here anyway, so you're not going to see it. You'll just see the legs poking underneath. So, that's my plan. What do you think? It's time to play pass or fail. So, if you think my plan's going to work and it's going to look nice, and hit the like button. But if you think it's gonna look rubbish, not gonna look nice at all, bear in mind this is my first blend, then hit the dislike button. Thumbs down button. You won't be able to see the dislike apparently now on YouTube, but I will. So whichever one you choose, it doesn't matter to me. And remember, right at the end, when you see the end product, if you feel, I ticked the like button, but it ended up a bit rubbish, so I want to change my mind, do so. Or if you thought, that's going to look rubbish, it's never done it before, and then you think, in fact, that was quite nice, then hit the like button. Or just comment that you would hit the like button, because you've already hit one, hopefully. And after all, it's only a game. I'm learning and I'm enjoying it, to be honest. It's good fun. So the first thing to do then is to scuff sand it. Scuff sanding, all I'm going to do is take the factory finish off. I'm not going to take much of anything off, just this shiny factory finish, because it might bleed through into the paint. I'm not going to prime with the paint, because the paint that I've got says you don't need to. So give that a go. I might not need to. But if I do, then I'll know. may just need an extra layer, extra couple of layers of paint. So without further ado, I'll stiff sand this, get the shiny parts off, and then I'll attach the legs. Once that's done, I can start painting, really. Great stuff. Oh, and take these things off as well, which I'll do first. So, times eight, actually, and we'll listen to some music. Great stuff. Enjoy. Actually metal. I thought it was plastic. Who'd have thought? Still gonna go though. I'm gonna try the old iron trick. Remember from the coffee table? Because that's stuck on. It's metal as well, so it's gotta be glue. So I'll give it a go with the iron. If you ever struggle with that, you know, the trim thing, I couldn't do it. Comes off in one strip. I'll have to use some filler just to fill in there. That's not a big deal. Didn't use an iron either. Chisel. As you can see, I hope you can see, that the finish has just been taken off now, so it's all done. I'll do exactly the same to this once all the wood filler has dried, so it'll probably take, what, overnight? And once that's done, I can do the same to those, and then I'm going to start blending. Now, the one thing I don't know, which I'll have to look, here. There's not much room for blending on here, is there? So I'll just paint it as I would do with a drawer line. Maybe try. It might work when I do the sides. So, yeah. So I'm gonna cut up the pieces for the wood now on the bottom. That's my next job. Enjoy. Great stuff. Now I'm just gonna, it's been overnight. I start taking the excess wood filler, and let's see how it turned out. Tip top. Feels like it was always a part of the wood. Obviously that line, different colour to that, but we're painting it. So I'll get rid of all of this, scuffs on the front, and then we'll attach the legs. I've got everything I need over there, so times eight, listen to music, have some fun. Enjoy. That the wood isn't too thick so the drawers won't work properly. So I've got my wood, I've made sure it's straight, that's always a bonus, and as you can see, quite thick, but plenty of room. So what I'll do is I'll leave about a couple of centimetres from the top, and then attach these hopefully in a straight line, and then the legs won't get wobbly. So first thing to do is to measure that and measure this and cut it, and there we go, we can attach the legs. And then start painting. Let's go. Twice, cut once, almost made a mistake. Now, when I cut this, I need to make sure that the 30 inches that I need is all here. So I need to make sure that the 30 is on the outside of the blade. So when it cuts, that part will be 30, and that won't be. across now to attach, so I can put the legs on them. It's all done, level, seems to be good, strong. Got the legs, so they'll go on the bottom of them. Now, I was going to attach them straight away, but I need to get this finish off, so I need to scuff sand them. So I may as well paint them in the grey, the dark grey, to match the bottom, and then I'll attach them at the end, or at least before I start the blending process. So I'll give it a scuff sand, paint the legs dark grey, turn the chest of drawers right way up, give it a couple of coats of the base coat before I start blending, and then flip it on its back, attach the legs, flip it over again, and then do the blending tomorrow, because I'll need 2 hours for the paint to dry for the first coat. Scuff sand it down just to smoothen it out. Maybe there'll be some brush marks or little drips that I might encounter. So that'll get rid of all of that, a smooth finish. And then give it another coat. And then I have to wait then till tomorrow to start the blending process. So I'll scuff these, paint them, set them aside, base coat. There we go, a thumb. Right, I'll get on with it now then, shall I? First coat. Now you'll notice when I was brushing, never go from the side inwards, always brush out, because when you brush out you won't get any dribble marks or any paint marks on the actual side that you wanted. So because this is going on the thing, I'll give you a demonstration. As you can see, all that, there's nothing on here. When you start doing it from the edge down, you get all this built up. Where are you? See it? All built up there. And that's how bubbles start and all that. So always smooth that off. Flick away from the side. It works on everything. It'll work on here. Oh, couldn't see that there. Here we go. You'll see that there's no build up on the side here, it's just where you want the paint. So flick away from the sides. That's the four legs done. I'm hoping they grow, you know, they dry a bit darker, to be honest. That's what I would like. But I'm impressed. They're really nice. They look good. And now, wait for those for 2 hours, give them another coat. In the meantime, I'll go to the drawers and give their first coat. Okay. Might as well use the same one. Dark grey in the bottom. Now,
dark grey, middle grey, light grey. So I don't need these in there at the moment, I can paint them individually. And then obviously I can, when I blend, I can either move the colours up or I can move the colours down. So I'll take these out and I'll just paint them. That's going to be a lot easier. Oh, I should do. In fact, I'll get it from the side. So then I know that this is my line. Nice. Okay, I've left the middle one in there on purpose, and then I can make. I went to the camera there, so I can make another line here, and then I've got my three. Yeah. It doesn't matter that this is a little bit higher than what people might say. Oh, I mean, I need that because I can move the colour down a bit if I need to. We just need to see what the contrast is like for the. For the other two. So what we'll do now is we'll do the top one first, allow that one to dry a little bit, and go from there. Show you something. Right. These are the two paints I've just used. Which one's the lighter one and which one's the darker one? See, to me, that's the lightest and that is the one after. And yet, that seems to be the lightest than that one. So, the winter grey, which I thought was darker than the flint, isn't. So, winter grey, flint. I'll just have to, on the second coat, I'll just flip them around if I need to. It's only a base coat anyway, so just to get the, to get it off. So we'll see what we can do with that one. So what I might have to do is switch them around on the next coat. It's only a base coat, so that's just to hide the any bleed through that may come through, because obviously it was pretty dark chest of drawers, and I'm putting a very light colour without primer, because Rust-Oleum says no primer required. So essentially this can be my primer. I mean, you can see there's three distinct. It's just that these two needs to be flipped. We'll do that later. Right, now it's time to blend. I've got my Mr. Bottle full of water, because the water needs to be wet when you want to blend the colours. I have my Winter Grey, which I thought was that one, but it's actually that one. And Flint, which I thought was that one, but it's actually that one. Good enough. So for this, we need at least four brushes. So we've got top brush, we've got the middle brush, we've got a lower colour brush, and a neutral brush. So, let's start. So, which is which? First of all, mist the area with water to get it damp. Apply skin. A little bit, just a little bit of paint. And just start going over where we've done. I'm going to try and bring this down slightly. Feather it across. Touch more. Now, mist. And work up. As light as a feather. That's not bad. Right. Let's try the bottom part now. I'm going to try and bring that down slightly. So I'll get my anthracite with its own brush. We'll be right back. looking at the camera and looking at this, and it's totally different. This looks really good from the eyes. This line you can see right here, you can't see that here. That's not a bad go. That was the joint originally, so as you can see, I pulled it down quite a bit because obviously we've got the legs, so it's going to be a little bit higher, and you want the darker tone to be at the bottom, don't you? That's not a bad first attempt. Right, I'll go and do the others, and let's see what the final thing will be. So I take it the next will be the reveal. Let's go. Right, here we are. So now let's recap. Do you remember how it used to look? As you can see, fairly dated. And I didn't look really nice today, so here we are, finally the reveal. So it went from this to this. I didn't do the stenciling on top because I don't think it would have brought anything to it. Because it looks like a pretty modern piece now, by putting the stenciling on it, I think it would just try and make it look older, but it didn't need it. Also, the handles. I've gone away from the black ones. I bought the black ones, I put them on, they didn't look right on it. So I bought these more modern handles. Because as you can see, it does look like a modern piece now. So the legs, they worked out pretty well on it as well. It's nice and sturdy, it's flat, always a bonus. And the blend. What do you think for a first attempt? I think it's darn good. The sides, you can see it better on the sides. But you can definitely see from the winter grey down to the flint and down to the anthracite. And it's fairly seamless. I did bring the anthracite down a bit because, well, I didn't want it to overpower. And because it's a bit higher, you like your darker ones down the bottom, don't you? So what do you think? Was it a pass? Or was it a fail? Let me know. But I'm chuffed to bits with this, to be honest with you. I think it's a damn good job. Now, I don't know what I'm going to do with it yet, whether I'm going to sell it, give it away, or raffle it off. Let me know. Comment down below if this is something that people might want. What would you do with it? So there we go. Sorry it took a long time, but I didn't anticipate, you know, having to leave the wood filler overnight. It got 3 coats, which took 2 days, just for the base coat alone. The blend itself, that was only the 1 coat, because I'm not quite sure you can re-coat a blend, because you can just be painting over it, won't you? So, the handles, because I had to change them, and I had to re-buy some more. It did take its time, I will admit, but I think it's turned out quite well. Yeah. So, that is it for my finished first project. I will be posting some more, some scrapwood ones, some scrapwood builds,
So stay tuned for that one. Right, remember, recycle, reuse, upcycle. Bye for now.